¿Será que es porque no soy gángster ni bichote como él? Coelho que te estoy tirando al ser. Anoche estábamos chingando y hoy no me puedes ver. Mami, con él te sobra mi...
Dime a ver, mi gente, I'm Jenny Mota, and welcome to Boiler Room and Ballantine's Deconstructed series. El objetivo de la serie is to push music culture forward by sharing tips, tricks, and insights by industry giants. Y por eso, I'm here with Colombian songwriter and global producer, Sky Rompiendo.
Yo.
Hey, and we're gonna break down one of my favorite tracks in his global hit, Chimbita, alongside Fade. So let's get to it. Sky, you started off super young as a beat maker in your room. Then at one point, you're in your late teens and you're working with J Balvin, literally as he's rising and making mad noise. And for that same reason, I think you're the perfect person to explain and define what reggaeton colombiano, reggaeton paisa is and what makes it different.
Yeah, first, yeah, thank you. Thank you for that. And when reggaeton got to us, it didn't got to us like at first from like, Puerto Rico, like when they got from Puerto Rico, it was like reggaeton, but before that, it was like Panama and a lot of reggae and stuff that got here to the clubs. So we started, you know, mixing that whole vibe, and then reggaeton got here, and people here start like getting crazy about that. I think that's how like reggaeton spread here.
So a fundamental part of this conversation is the production process, and I'd love to know what are the programs you're using?
Yeah, so right now I'm on Live on Ableton, but I started on FO Studio, like on Fruity Loops when I was a kid. I did a bunch of records there. I did a bunch of, you know, records that went big, Balvin ones. And then when I got to the point I could afford, you know, a MacBook, I switched to Ableton because before, like, you cannot run FL on Mac.
Yeah.
Talking about like a geek of a bunch of geek stuff, but. You guys understand me.
Those that know, those that get it, get it. So the track opens up and it has like really strong, to me, nostalgic effects. And I want to know how you got to that. Like, what were the beginning cues?
Yeah, so, you know, I'm making music with Fade like every day. You know, if he's not on tour, if he's not, you know, over there, like, he's a very like, creative guy, you know, in every aspect. So he always gets to the studio with certain like goodies that mm-hmm. you know, get to the session like and make the session like the workflow like very easy. So that day he got to the studio with this, with these chords, you know, and I was like, yo, you got something there, you know, like shoot me those. And we started like building out of there. So yeah, the song starts like I just like the progression that he had, and then from there we started like writing this story that it's a very like common story here, you know. It's like a girl from the hood that you know, all these guys with money and shit, they want to go and they want to, you know, take her away from the hood,
romanticize her, and...
yeah. So but she doesn't want that. She wants the kid from the hood, you know, that mm-hmm. ones that, you know, stays in the dirt bike and this and that. So it's talking about that. And that's a common story here, like, or in any part of the world, right?
So you have the beginning, you guys have the chord progressions. What happened next?
Yeah, so like, yeah, we started to get like dramatic, you know, like some mellotron, you know, very like dramatic, like strings.
Very dramatic. Nice.
You know, to give it like a little intro. And I start layering with a bunch of stuff, you know, like with the...
Oof.
Yeah, so I get to there, it's like a big intro for this like very simple, you know, just the lead vocal and his chords.
Where did these, like, the omnience in these vocals, where did that come from, like?
Man, I've been telling you stuff that Faye gets to the studio with those goodies that I can, you know, I'm like, yo, where is this coming from?
Was that something that was already pre-recorded?
No, and, like, he just had, like, a vocal, and I started, like, sampling, like, the vocal, and we ended up here, you know, like, yeah. So he had like a long,
that
you know,
so late.
And then we started like, exactly. And this is very simple, but you know, the vocals making everything right now. Then we started like arranging everything, and then I think like the most important thing of this song is the drums. You know, like I think like these drums, not only on this song, when I do drums that, you know, that go like beyond of like, oh, we released the song and maybe some people liked it or some people don't. When it crosses that, when it gets like very big, I like to keep those drums, you know, and like start like putting them on other songs and maybe like giving like a little twist. That's a thing that I'm doing like from a like 2 years from like ago.
So what drums have you used? These drums?
I invented these for this song, but from there, like you can hear these on Que Más Puedes, and like that, nice. You know. I just make my little like twitches, you know, on the drums, and I change a little shit. But when I hear like it gives like a little, you know, vibe and a little groove, I like to keep them like for certain things. So I think like this is the very important thing of this song. It's like very simple, but like, you know, like very like, yeah, from roots, and the samples I use are like samples from way back, you know, like Blas.
Hey, you know, shout out to DJ Blas.
Yeah, of course. Nelson. I use a lot of like oldies samples. Like per se, like there's like this feel right here. That's very like popular before. Like you know, those type of like the timpanis and stuff, like those type of details, like we grew up with that. So exactly. This is a song like where we got inspired by the reggaeton that made us.
Yeah.
You know, and then by the stories that made us as well, you know.
Yeah. And these are vocals that he already had that you...
Yeah, there was like this long vocal that we started like sampling it. And then this like mellotron as well. It's like very old, like type of strings. They're not like, they don't feel real, you know, real 100%, but they in between. I like that. They're very dirty and stuff. But yeah, so the track keeps going, and it's very simple at the beginning. It goes with the chords, and then these little like keys that I just, you know, like some sequence there. Bass as well. It's the same thing. You only have here. You only have the cellos and the chords and his vocal. That's the arrangement in the music in the hook, you know, like very simple in the A part. Then and in the second hook, I started like messing around more. Oh, here. And I added like another melody.
Why do you feel like we're in this space of nostalgia? Of just like, we're kind of bringing a lot of these rhythms and like styles back.
You know, that happens everywhere. You know, in fashion, that happens in music. That's history, you know? Mm-hmm. So I think it's like, right now we have like some loose jeans. Maybe in 10 years we're gonna have skinny jeans again.
Yeah.
Who knows, you know? So like everything comes back in a different format. You get the nostalgic thing, but you don't feel like you're hearing an old song.
Exactly,
you know?
Yeah. I was just gonna say.
But that's the generation that's like, you know, trying to get, you know, their position. And, and of course we have the Bad Bunnies, we have the Raus that take those risks as well. Mm-hmm. But like for these kids that they didn't, you know, live through that, it's like very important for them, like getting that vibe from the new artists, because they wouldn't get it if it wasn't because of the guys that are on top right now.
Yeah.
They didn't listen to Yankee 20 years ago. They didn't listen to Wisin Yandel 20 years ago. So they need to hear that type of thing right now, not on the old ones, but you know, the guys that are right now.
And in terms of towards the ending and just the way everything progresses.
Yeah, like I mean, like the song ending here, right? And then we had the idea, you know? We had the idea of like, when we were at the studio, I told him like, let's try to, because that's cliche. Putting a girl from Medellin to talk in reggaeton is cliche. Mm-hmm. But I had the idea of like, let's try to make the credits, you know, like every artist does like, oh, Sky, mm-hmm. blah, 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 boom, so she can make the credits, but not in a way where she's like shouting out to us. It's just like, yo, let's hang out with Sky, you know, Sky, Faye, you know, like, and we did like that format of like the shout outs at the end of the, you know.
Yeah, Medellin loves reggaeton, like, early 2000s, underground, like they love the lo panameño.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's not something that you'll just hear once in a blue. It's like you pass by clubs and establishments and people are blasting Tego Calderon, Don Omar, like everyone.
We all have like the biggest respect for like reggaeton and that meaning Boricuas and Puerto Rico, you know. Bunch of respect, man, like for each of these guys that made it through here and made the first concerts here, like Yankee, Wisin Yandel, Queen, Tego Calderon, Don Omar, Nicky Jam. That group was the influence here, you know, that made the whole movement here like think like, yo, they're doing concerts in our city.
And I know a lot of people mentioned like Golpe a Golpe.
Yeah, nah, shout out, that's what I'm saying. Shout out to all the, you know, all the Universidad La Calle and all the, you know, the different cliques that were at that day.
When it comes to this track, how is it representative to Medellin y el reggaeton que está saliendo de la ciudad?
I mean, this is a very, like, first the story of the song is a very common story here in Medellin again. So it's like pretty much like the things that we lived. And it talked like specific things, you know, like, specific dirt bike they use here, specific place, specific things that, you know, people from Medellin knows about. And then the song, it brings that old schoolness in it that we all love here. If you put the radio, if you play the radio, you're gonna listen to an old school track. If you go to a neighborhood at 10 a.m. when they, like, you know, they doing, they cleaning the house, you're gonna listen to old school reggaeton. Everywhere you're gonna listen to old school reggaeton. So at the end of the day, it's what we like as paisas in Medellin, you know, so. Yeah, it's pretty much it. And then, you know, Fercho Faye has become like this artist that represent the kids here, you know, the kids that live the day to day, they go to school, they go to university, but, you know, they wanna have that girl, they wanna have that car, they wanna have this and that, so, yeah.
Well, Sky, thank you so much for taking me on this sonic journey. It was really dope and interesting to see the different aspects and touches and effects that you used on this track. I think that everyone else will enjoy as well. Again, this is Boiler Room and Ballantine's Deconstructed series. It's actually the last episode.
Yeah.
We chose Medellin as the last episode, and we're celebrating la cultura del reggaeton que está saliendo de aquí and the vibes. So thank you so much. And this is
Gracias.
A wrap. I'm gonna give you a hug.
Of course.